This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about probability for independent and dependent events. So here's our example. I've got some pieces that I took from a Scrabble game. There are two squares and they have A's on them. And there are two squares, two pieces, and they have E's on them. If I put these pieces into a bag and shook the bag, and just randomly drew one of the pieces, I would have a 50% chance of getting an A, since there are two A's and four pieces altogether. I'd also have a 50% chance of getting an E, because there are two E's and four pieces altogether. So I could represent these probabilities with a tree. I'd have these two branches for the tree. One branch would represent getting an A, and the other would represent getting an E. And my probability for getting an A would be 1/2. The probability for getting an E would be 1/2. Now, if I want to play this game again, or run this experiment again, I've got two choices. I could either take the letter that I picked and put it back in the bag, or I could not put it back in the bag. We're going to get a different probability the second time around, depending on whether we replace that letter or not. So let's look at both of those options. If I put the letter back in the bag, then once again, there are two A's in the bag and two E's in the bag. So the probabilities the second time around haven't changed at all. They're independent of what I picked the first time. If I want to figure out the probability of getting an A after I got an A the first time, well, the second time, I'm still going to have a 1/2 probability of getting an A, and I'll have a 1/2 probability of getting an E. And the same kind of probabilities would happen if I picked an E the first time around. If I put it back in the bag, if I replaced it, then my probability for getting an A on the second turn would be 1/2, and my probability for getting an E on the second turn would be 1/2. So we can take this tree and figure out what the probability would be of getting two A's in a row. All we have to do is follow the branch of the tree that gives me two A's in a row and multiply the probabilities each time. So I've got a probability of 1/2 from the first time that I got an A, and then a probability of 1/2 for the second time that I got an A. So that's 1/2 times 1/2. And that multiplies out to 1/4, or 1/4. Okay? Now, when I did that, I replaced the piece that I took. Whatever I took, I replaced it. I put it back in the bag. So we could call that probability with replacement. We could also talk about that as being two independent events, because the probabilities for the second time around did not depend on what I picked the first time around. The second time around, my probability of getting an A was 1/2, my probability of getting an E was 1/2, and that didn't depend on whether I got an A the first time or an E the first time. So these are called independent events. In other words, the probability for the second event was independent of the probability for the first event. Now let's see what would have happened if we played that game differently. Let's say that we did this with what are called dependent events. So we would start out the same way. I would have the same four letters, I would put them in the bag, and I would randomly pick one of the letters. So my probability, once again, for getting an A is 1/2, and my probability for getting an E is 1/2. Now let's say that this time I don't replace the letter that I picked. So let's say I get an A and I don't put it back in the bag. Okay, so now on the second turn, what's my probability for getting an A? Well, it's no longer 1/2. I've only got one A left in the bag and there are three letters in the bag. So my probability of getting an A the second time around is only 1/3. My probability of getting an E is 2/3. If I had gotten an E the first time and didn't replace it, then my probabilities would change again. If I'd gotten an E the first time and didn't replace it, there would be two A's in the bag and only one E. So now my probability of getting an A would be 2/3. And my probability of getting an E would be 1/3. And if I want to know the probability of getting two A's in a row, I'll figure that out the same way I did before. I'll take the branch of the tree that has two A's in a row, and I'll multiply 1/2, the probability from the first time, times 1/3, the probability from the second time, and 1/2 times 1/3 is 1/6, 1/6. So these are called dependent events, because the probabilities that I end up with the second time around depend on what happened the first time. The probabilities the second time for getting an A or getting an E are different if I got an A the first time than if I got an E the first time. And that happened because in a game like this, when I took the pieces out, I did not replace them. So this is probability without replacement. Okay? So just to go over this one more time quickly. The probability for independent events doesn't change from one event to the next depending on what happened previously. Okay? If we're dealing with pieces like Scrabble pieces or cards or something like that, it would mean that we replace the pieces that we took the first time so that the odds, so the probabilities remain the same. If we're dealing with dependent events, then the probabilities for the second event are going to depend on what happened on the first event. And in a game like this one, it's because we played the game without replacement. Okay? So that's basically independent and dependent events and their probabilities. Take care. I'll see you next time.